Now that you know all about how monosaccharides can form ring structures, we can discuss how two monosaccharides can be joined together to form a disaccharide. Joining of monosaccharide units occurs via a condensation reaction, in which the atoms of water are removed. For example, when the hydroxyl on carbon 1 of beta-galactose reacts with the hydroxyl of carbon 4 of glucose, two hydrogens and an oxygen are lost, and the disaccharide lactose is formed. The bond that is formed is called an O-glycosidic bond. When an O-glycosidic bond is formed between two monosaccharides, at least one of the enomeric carbons is involved. For lactose, the enomeric carbon of galactose is involved in the bond, but not the enomeric carbon of glucose. Even though the enomeric carbon of galactose no longer has a hydroxyl group on it, you can tell whether its configuration is alpha or beta by comparing the position of the oxygen of the O-glycosidic bond with that of the highest numbered carbon. For example, in lactose, the oxygen of the O-glycosidic bond is pointing up on the top side of the pyranose ring of galactose. The highest numbered carbon of galactose is on the same side of the ring, and therefore the galactose group of lactose is in the beta configuration. When the enomeric carbon is involved in an O-glycosidic bond, the ring containing that enomeric carbon can no longer open and close. Therefore, the monosaccharide group is stuck or frozen in the enomeric configuration it was in when the bond was made. So, in the disaccharide lactose, the galactose sugar is always in the beta configuration. We name the linkage between two monosaccharides as follows. First, we give the enomeric configuration of the monosaccharide linked via its enomeric carbon. Then, we give the numbers of the two carbons involved in the linkage, usually separated by an arrow. Thus, the bond joining galactose and glucose and lactose is called a beta-1,4 linkage, because carbon 1 of galactose in the beta configuration is joined to carbon 4 of glucose. Note that because the enomeric carbon of glucose is not involved in an O-glycosidic bond, the glucose ring can still open and close. The enomeric carbon of the glucose part of the molecule can interconvert between the beta and alpha configurations. The lactose molecule as a whole is designated alpha or beta based on the configuration of the hydroxyl on the enomeric carbon of the glucose part. So the structure shown here is beta lactose. If the hydroxyl on the enomeric carbon of glucose is on the opposite side of the pyranose ring from the highest numbered carbon in glucose, the molecule is alpha lactose. As you might expect, cells do not limit themselves to forming only disaccharides. In the next video, we will consider longer chains in which many monosaccharides are joined together.